Alistair Cook and Andrew Strauss head for the middle to start the third test match. Lovely timing from Alistair Cook. What about that? Yeah, well, the revenue! What a good one from Jerome Taylor. What a surprise for Andrew Strauss, who didn't seem to be troubled by the idea of the appeal. But Alim Dar had his finger up immediately, no doubt in his mind. Four. Michael Vaughan is off the mark, and that gets cheers. Terrific stroke from Alistair Cook. Nicely timed. Great stroke. Bold.
A cracker. He's got some talent, this lad. Shot. Oh, well, he bowled it wide of off stump, tempting Cook, and he was up to it.
Oh dear, that's dismissed by Michael Vaughan. No respect there for Darren Sammy's first over in Test cricket. It sat up and was deposited at a rate of knots straight to square leg to bring up the England 100. That's a good shot. There's nothing wrong with that delivery. What a princely shot from Michael Vaughan. Guided through the offside. Could this be the Cook 50? He's got enough on it. It will be. So just before lunch, Alistair Cook goes to yet another 50 for England.
Oh, bold. Bowled beautifully, thought out. That's why he's bowling. West Indies have tried to keep a tight hold of the run rate, frustrate the England batsmen and wait for them to make a mistake. And I think Michael Vaughan there, he's made a mistake trying to drive on the up. Oh, well, that wasn't really a bad ball. Might have been a little bit of wit, but it wasn't a half volley.
Too good. Alistair Cook's been quickly onto the back foot at every opportunity. There's a man back, surely out, is out. Kevin Peterson has hit it straight down the throat of Dwayne Bravo. Peterson made it clear that he thought he'd batted like a Muppet at Lord's. I wonder what he'll say about himself there. Oh, good ball, good ball. What a length that is from Darren Sammy. This is a terrific period by the West Indians. Suddenly we've got a real contest on our hands. Oh, did that carry? I think it might have carried. Alistair Cook will certainly stand. It could just be a fantastic catch. Dwayne Bravo is the man who's just caught out Kevin Peterson. Now he's got Alistair Cook as well, has he? That, Ian Bishop, is a tremendous take.
Well, they've been tied down, both these batsmen, but there again, that's as good a shot as we've seen played today. Just rocked back, picked it up very quickly and took it from way outside off stump.
Nicely played, Ian Bell. That's a typical shot that gained pace as well as it went through the cover area. Probably just slipping down the leg side. No, says Alim Dar. He's given him out. So Collingwood's rather torrid innings comes to an end, and it was a good bit of bowling by Jerome Taylor, probing away outside off stump, then bringing one back. I thought maybe they'd done a bit too much, but not the umpire, and Collingwood's on his way.
Oh, what a good shot. That is a good shot. That was one of those balls on your legs, on your pads, that you clip away for a couple, but he's put it away really well for four. Oh, what a majestic shot. There's been some tight bowling, and he's creamed that on the up through the covers as prior. He won't play a better shot tonight than that.
Beautiful straight drive. Mm. Beautiful, Jeffrey.
So simplistic, wasn't it? Well, that's 50 for Ian Bell. I don't think he meant it there. He was trying to hit it firmly through the offside, but he got enough bat on it that it slipped off the face down to third man.
Pulled by Pryor very effectively between the two men. Has he got the carry? No. It's straight down the throat, so the sucker punch administered to another England batsman, Matt Pryor. goes on his way, happy hooking.
What a bit of timing that is. Liam Plunkett just stood tall. What a cracker. What a way to finish the day. Fast and full and straight against the tail end.
Day two is such an important one for the West Indies. They must look to build on the good work that they did on day one.
Well, that's ironic, really. It was the right idea from Jerome Taylor. He just slightly got that too wide.
Oh dear, that's quick and that's out, is it? Yep, that's out. A nod from Billy Bowden. Quite why he doesn't put up his finger, I don't know, but... Beautiful driving. Oh, and Bell moves into the 90s with it.
Now is that gone? Yes, it's gone. The finger goes up. Collymore once again finds bounce and movement from a hard surface. Bell has fought hard. And on 97, he falls agonizingly short.
And that is executed very well. In good control of the pull shot this time.
Listen to this cheer, listen to the applause. Monty Panesar is a crowd favourite anywhere he goes.
Oh, look at this. This is fantastic for England. Monty smacks that away. Out. That is definitely out, but West Indies can smile over that. So can Fidel Edwards, but that's 32 priceless runs these tail-enders have put on. Leg buys. I don't think he hit that. Oh, he didn't nick. No, he didn't. That's out. He stayed back to a very full-length ball. I think if he didn't hit that, that's absolutely plumb, no doubt at all. He misread the length, and I'm not surprised there. Ball's going down leg side, wides all over the place. I bet he was surprised, was Ganga, with a straight ball. Oh, again, that should tell him everything, Harmison. Pitched the ball up. What an absolute beauty that was.
How did that bowl him? I can't believe that ball. Devon Smith can't believe it either. That's a cracking stroke. Need too much footwork the way Chris Gayle plays. What a ball that is. Unbelievable delivery, given not out. Terrific cut shot. Almost a perfect example of how to play it. For once, Gayle wasn't trying to hit the ball too hard. Look at that. Gayle goes. It's Alistair Cook who takes the catch. Michael Vaughan's bowling change has worked.
Good shot. That's straight and pitched up, and he's hit that really crisply. Oh, what a shot. There's a man in top form, very confident. Now, don't throw it away.
Catch it.
Well, he's an amazing player, this Morton. He's had 11 balls and he's tried to hit every one.
What a strike. My heaven, he's an exciting talent, this man. Great strike. Morton has power and he has confidence at present. And he's looking at every chance to strike the board of the boundary too. Well done, Stephen Harmison. You can't believe it, can you? Here's a man who can't find himself, let alone the pitch, some balls, and then produces other stuff that batsmen can't play. It's Renato Morton that's gone as well.
Oh, catch me!
Catchy, catchy. That could be out. That could be out. I think it is. They're going to discuss it, the umpires. We had a good look, did the umpire from the bowler's end. Devon Smith is gone. 157 for four.
Get on it.
Good shot. Really good shot from a man who's just come in. Beautifully played. Shot. Like it. Lovely little wristy flick and perfect timing from Chanderpaul. Good shot. Again, that's Chanderpaul at his best.
What a stroke. What control and excitement as he played it. nicely taken. Matt Pryor tumbling to his right side. Ryan Sidebottom has his first wicket in first-class cricket at Old Trafford. England have Dwayne Bravo, that's the most important thing. And everybody's alive again.
For Shivnarine Chanderpaul is 42nd in Test match cricket. A type of determined, experienced effort. And the West Indies missed at Headingley, but they have here today. This is in the air and out, a soft dismissal, but good reward for Sidebottom. Again, he hits the pitch hard. And we spoke about the extra effort he's put in this spell, and it's just too quick on to Ramdin. Spin, big spin from Panesar. England are on a roll here in this final session on this second day, and Sammy's short sojourn comes to an end. Two in the over for Monty Panesar. The energy is there, the vibe is there, and he's cutting a swathe through the West Indians. It's the end of a resilient innings from Chanderpaul. The question was asked, could Sidebottom do it at a ground other than Headingley? Did he have the pace? Did he have the variety? He's answered a few questions today. Gone. The West Indies innings is over. They've lost their last five wickets for five runs. And Monty Panesar has finished with a four-wicket haul. What a last half an hour it's been for England.
What a good ball! Yes, LAW! Fidel Edwards with an in-swinger. A tricky period indeed for Andrew Strauss, who is having a miserable run of it. Lovely, you love him there. And you can really feel the intensity of the moment. And Cook is easing into his strokes at the moment. Increasingly, he looks a classy player. I think we knew he was a gutsy player. And that's five. As if we haven't had enough to enjoy and be amazed by today. It doesn't go down for the batsman, goes down as extras. And incredibly, extras have now gone to 100 in the match. And we're only at the end of the second day. Fabulous from Michael Vaughan. That lights up the morning. Oh, Alistair Cook has no trouble with those.
Oh, he's taken it. Completely out of the blue, Darren Sammy has grabbed the caught and bowled. Michael Vaughan can't believe it. He's got to turn around and wander back to the pavilion, having middled one that he was probably expecting to see rattling into the boundary boards a couple of seconds later.
Should be 50 for Alistair Cook, continuing a rich vein of form in his Test career and in this series. Great shot. Very solid shot off the back foot from Alistair Cook. He's good off the front foot, good through the leg side.
There's a brilliant square drive. Now, there's few players can do that. Fetch that. When Peterson is good, he is very good.
Well played, Kevin Peterson. Very simple single to bring up a nice 50.
Oh, that's hit him. And that's gone onto the wicket as well. He's dismissed Peterson with a dramatic delivery. Dwayne Bravo has done it again for the West Indies, coming up with something unexpected, which not only has dismissed Peterson, but it's hurt him as well.
Can you believe the celebration? That's the enthusiasm of the man, Bravo.
Should be the 600 in Test match cricket for Alistair Cook. Moments of fortune early on, but he's gone on to a commanding innings here at Old Trafford, his second 100 of the series.
Sparkling use of the feet by Paul Collingwood.
He'd given him. It was almost a solitary appeal from Chris Gayle, the bowler. It seems so nonchalant, but Alim Dar has raised the finger.
Mightn't be a bad decision. It's hit him between wicket and wicket. Well, Hawkeye doesn't really agree with me. A shame for Alistair Cook. He has indicated to everybody that he is a formidable England batsman, despite that finger.
Oh, a bowl. Beautifully bowled. Darren Sammy making everything come really into the right-hander. Makes one hold its line. Very gentle pace, but Bell seemed to be surprised and almost follow it. Oh, a bowl, oh, bowl. I think that's out. It is. Well bowled indeed, young man. First ball, two wickets in two balls. And he's on a hat-trick. No wonder he's going wild and they're all jumping on top of him.
Enthusiasm in its rawest form.
Oh, shouting. Has he hit it? What are they shouting? LBW caught to what? They think he's out. They think it's hit the bat. He's going. He's gone. Well, well. Three wickets in five balls for Darren Sammy. What a match. After England been so much on top.
Inside edge. And Dwayne Bravo with more memorable athleticism. I mean, that's a classic picture. Nothing for Plunkett either. 2 for 7.
Oh, it's a good shot. Gayle is trying to keep him tied down at that end so that Sammy could bowl it to Harmison, but he's clipped it straight back over his head. Oh, what a shot. What a shot from Harmison. Oh, well caught. Very, very good catch. Didn't go too quickly, but it looped it in the air. He had to make a bigger ground to it.
That's out. Collingwood's gone. Just hanging his head there, trying to chip that one away over the leg side. And he's on his way for 42. But it's now six wickets for Darren Sammy. What a day for the man from St. Lucia. Out, seven wickets for Darren Sammy, 7 for 66, the second best performance by a West Indian on debut of all time. England bowled out for 313, which means the West Indies need 455 to win.
Gosh, that has to be LBW. It is LBW. Steve Harmison is the man. Darren Ganga goes. Poor Darren Ganga. This is a miserable baptism as captain of the West Indies. Wow. The great thing about Chris Gayle is he'll keep entertaining us, whatever the scorecard.
Excellent first over, no wides, a maiden, and he made the batsman play 4 out of 6. Oh, good delivery. That cut away from leg stump and bounced as well. In fact, Gayle in the end did extremely well to not manage to palm it to gully. That's a good shot. Typical Chris Gayle. Quite uncomplicated in style. Standing on the back foot and swatting it through the offside from Harmison. There it is, and it's out. That's a brilliant bit of bowling by Steve Harmison. He's explored various lengths of Chris Gayle, but his line has been fantastic. And at last, he deserved a result, which is sending Chris Gayle back. West Indies 35 for 2.
There's lovely placement.
Straight away, full toss and smacked it down the ground. I think the game on here, real challenge between bowler and batsman.
Catch it!
Oh, well, they always shout catch it. Yes, he's got him. We couldn't really see there for the batsman's body, but we knew he was causing problems to the left-hander. It was a matter of time when he hit those footholds and the ball spun and bounced. It's very, very difficult with men close in if you bowl well at a man with all those footholds there. Good shot. Good shot. He's a very good driver of the ball, is Morton. Chop. Nice, juicy full toss. That's the way to play when your team's under pressure. You just push it away nicely. Hit it hard or hit it soft. As long as it gets to the boundary, you only get four.
That's a magnificent stroke. Almost seemed to get on his toes to play it, to dig out the full length and pick his spot.
Get on that.
That is a very fine piece of batting. Chanderpaul has waited his moment, prepared to pad away ball after ball, and won a fraction over pitched. And bingo.
Catch it!
Catch it! Catch it! Well, difficult. Nearly knocked him over, but it was a chance, you feel.
Get on up.
Yes. 50 runs for Renaco Morton. Only his third 50 in Test match cricket. It's been a muscular innings, but one that has been allied with patience and discipline and no shortage of skill. Panesar has worked hard for this. He's spun the ball, he's got it to bounce. Renaco Morton has played with a determined eye and great concentration, but patience has paid off for Monty Panesar.
Catch it!
Well played. Nobody back on the sweep. Vaughan ringing the changes here and just tempting Chanderpaul into having a bit of a go towards square leg, and he middled it perfectly. Good shot. Quite unorthodox from Dwayne Bravo. He did that very well, just helping that off his hit for four. And that's 50. Another one that really Chanderpaul enjoyed receiving, and that takes him to an excellent half century. It's been a very resourceful innings.
Oh, that's a good shot. That's a cracking shot. I don't think Monty Panesar should worry about it. He just tossed it up a little bit.
Fabulous shot. Fabulous. That's the way to play left arm spin.
Yeah, catch it!
Yes, got it. Monty Panesar. A long, hard toil, really, for Panesar. But he's got his just reward, I feel.
With good attacking stroke from Dinesh Ramdin.
That is a beauty. Fancy finding that ball in the last over of the day.
Salvation for the West Indies today lies firmly on the shoulders of Shivnarine Chanderpaul. No other batsman over the last 14 years for West Indies has been as dogged or determined. If he stays there until the end and control the innings, then the West Indies have hope.
In the air, but well played. Deliberately deposited over the top of that backward cover position. An effective boundary from Ramdin. Just a bit too short and wide from Harmison. Oh, well bowled. Oh, has that got the edge? It has. He's on his way. Brilliant bowling by Panesar. Deceived Ramdin for length, and he's made the crucial breakthrough. That's too short and wide from Harmison, though, and flayed away by Sammy in glorious style.
Catch it!
In the air, but wide of mid-off. A good shot, in fact. There's some positive stuff here from Darren Sammy. West Indies now just thinking about the run chase. 127 to win.
Catch it!
Oh, brilliant reaction from Panesar. Stunned Darren Sammy as well. It's a five-wicket haul for the left-arm spinner. And it spells disaster for the West Indies, and England can smell the scent of victory.
Well, credit to Panesar for continuing to toss the ball up. Sammy was ill-advised to try and drive this one.
Steve Harmison recorded the attack. England close in. Fielders on the offside, saving a single. Also a mid-wicket. He has 99, Chanderpaul. Now, what's that? Glove or thigh pad? He has 100. He won't forget this 100. What will this 100 lead to? It's an exceptional performance. You don't often see emotion from Shiv Chanderpaul, but that reaction tells you so much. Good shot. Four. What a really good sweep stroke. catch that? Yes, that's out. Thomason has a wicket. 200 test wickets in all he has. Fabulous achievement. He's bowled well here. After a great deal of work and thought has gone into the improved performance as well. And is returned again. Good catch. Edwards is out now. So Harmison has 201, but the most important figure is that England have 9. And again, Chanderpaul will get 2 and be able to retain the strike. This is such a clever innings. One of the best of its type you could ever wish to see.
Catch it!
Oh, what a catch! What a way to win the test match and win the series! Unbelievable performance! Ah, now hang on, the umpires are going to confer. So the drama is on hold. So's the result. Now, the third umpire is going to have to make a decision for us. He's into his pad and straight up to Ian Bell, who has snaffled it with his right mitt. And that's it. Out. Well, Peter Moores might smile, and well, they might dance. They had the most miserable winter. 11 consecutive home series without defeat. Michael Vaughan has returned to the side, recorded his 21st win as England captain, which goes past Peter May's record of 20.